In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. Well, the sun is shining brightly outside, and the love of John and Heather shining brightly here in this church this afternoon. And as we gather for their celebration of their nuptial blessing and their joint love for one another, we come together acknowledging God's presence. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that these your servants, now to be joined by the sacrament of matrimony, may grow in the faith they profess and enrich your church with faithful offspring. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated as we listen to the readings of Sacred Scripture.
A reading from the book of Tobit. On their wedding night, Tobiah arose from bed and said to his wife, "Sister, get up. Let us pray and beg our Lord to have mercy on us and to grant us deliverance." Sarah got up and they started to pray and begged that deliverance might be theirs. They began with these words, "Blessed are you, O God of our fathers. Praise be your name forever and ever. Let the heavens and all your creation praise you forever. You made Adam, and you gave him his wife Eve, to be his help and support. And from these two, the human race descended. You said, 'It is not good for the man to be alone. Let us make him a partner like himself.' Now, Lord, you know that I take this wife of mine, not because of lust, but for a noble purpose. Call down your mercy on me and on her, and allow us to live together to be a happy old age." They said together, "Amen, amen." The word of the Lord. A reading from the book of Psalms, chapter 145. Response. How good is the Lord to all? The Lord is kind and full of compassion, slow to anger, abounding in mercy. How good is the Lord to all? Compassionate to all his creatures. Response. How good is the Lord to all? All your works shall thank you, O Lord, and all your faithful ones bless you. The eyes of all look to you, and you give them their food in due season. How good is the Lord to all? The Lord is righteous in all his ways and holy in all his deeds. The Lord is close to all who call him, who call on him in truth. How good is the Lord to all?
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, I, a prisoner of the Lord, urge you to live in a manner worthy of the call that you have received, with all humility and gentleness, with patience, bearing with one another through love, striving to preserve the unity of the Spirit, through the bond of peace, one body and one Spirit, as you were also called to the one hope of your call, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is over all and through all and in all. This the word of the Lord.
Oh,
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. May the gospel message be on our minds, on our lips, and in our hearts. Jesus said to his disciples, "You are the salt of the earth. But if salt loses its taste, what can it be seasoned? It is no longer good for anything but to be thrown out and trampled underfoot. You are the light of the world. A city set on a mountain cannot be hidden, nor do they light a lamp and then put it under a bushel basket. It is set on a lampstand where it gives light to all in the house. Just so, your light must shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your heavenly Father." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated. It's a privilege to be here this afternoon with John and Heather as family and friends, to gather in an opportunity to experience and witness love of a man and woman, husband and wife. We're blessed to be here and to see and experience the joy of their love as we gather here and hear the readings that they've selected for this, their wedding day. The first reading comes from the book of Tobit, and it's the prayer of Tobiah, where Tobiah and his wife spend their first night at prayer when they're married. On their wedding night, it's their wedding prayer that we hear in the first reading. It's a beautiful prayer because it recalls from the very beginning the need for companionship of man and woman, husband and wife. And we hear the conclusion of the prayer. You said it is not good for the man to be alone. Let us make a partner. Now, Lord, you know that I take this wife of mine not because of lust, but for a noble purpose. Call down your mercy on me and her, and allow us to live together to a happy old age. A beautiful prayer to be witnessed not only with Tobiah and his wife, but for John and Heather. To look at our second reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians, it's a reading that explains and describes how we are to live our lives, what we really seek. And he says, "I urge you to live in a manner worthy of the call you have received, with all humility and gentleness, with patience, bearing with one another through love." That patience and that love are central to the lives that we live as husband and wife, as family and friends. And then our gospel reading talks to us and it describes that you are the light of the world, that we want to be enlightened by God's love and to share that light with others. And John and Heather, let your light shine, and let it shine in your family, in your friends, in your workplaces, and in the world in which we live, because we are blessed to experience and witness and share your love. I asked both John and Heather to share with me three things that they love about one another. And so I want to share with you this because this is their day. This is their love. And I want to share the love they have expressed for one another. And so we hear from John. Heather is the most loving, affectionate person I have ever met. To be the subject of that affection is to be loved honestly and truly. He also says, Heather is quick to laugh and joke. Our relationship has been filled with laughter as the result of her tendency toward lightheartedness. And he continues, Heather's faith is another thing I love about her. Her faith has encouraged me to deepen my own faith and find a voice with which to share it. And Heather shares her three. Heather says, what I love about John is his sense of humor. He always keeps me laughing. Wherever we are together feels like home. He is home to me. And I love his endless pursuit to keep us safe and secure in all things, whether it's our finances or safety and well-being. I know he will always take care of me. To find a home, to express that faith, and to share that love is a beautiful witness to this couple that we have before us. As we gather as family and friends, may we continue to support them as they begin their life together as husband and wife, and let their light shine in our lives as well as in the lives of the world in which we live. And with that, I'm going to ask Heather and John to please come forward. Dearly beloved, you have come together into the house of the church so that in the presence of the church's minister and the community, your intention to enter into marriage may be strengthened by the Lord with a sacred seal. Christ abundantly blesses the love that binds you. Through a special sacrament, he enriches and strengthens those he has already consecrated by holy baptism, that they may be faithful to each other forever and assume all the responsibilities of married life. And so, in the presence of the church, I ask that you state your intentions. John and Heather, have you come here to enter into marriage without coercion, freely and wholeheartedly? And are you prepared, as you follow the path of marriage, to love and honor each other for as long as you both shall live? And are you prepared to accept children lovingly from God and to bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church? Since it is your intentions to enter into the covenant of holy matrimony, I ask that you join your hands and declare your consent before God and his church.
I promise to love and honor you faithfully and truly for all the days of my life, forsaking all others, till death do us part.
I, Heather, take you, John, to have and to hold till this day forward in sickness and
Well, they whispered it, but I'm going to let you know what they said. They wanted to memorize this vow because it's something they live for the rest of their lives. And it was very personal as they shared it in a whisper, but it's a public ceremony, so I want to share with you what they said. John said, I take you, Heather, to be my wife. I promise to be faithful to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, to love you and to honor you all the days of my life. And Heather responded, I, Heather, take you, John, to be my husband. I promise to be faithful to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, to love you and honor you all the days of my life. And now we come to the blessing of the rings, which is an outward sign of that love that they have just exchanged with one another. Here they are. In Greek antiquity, physicians said that the third finger had a vein that went to the heart, and that this love represents the triune God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, uniting that heart to an outward sign of their commitment to love one another. And so may the Lord bless these rings, which you will give to each other as a sign of love and fidelity. Amen. Repeat after me. Heather, receive this ring.
Heather, receive this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
The Son.
The Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
John, receive this ring.
John, receive this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
The Son.
The Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
The Holy Spirit.
And you may now kiss your bride. And you may now return. And please stand. My dear brothers and sisters, let us now accompany this new family with our prayers, that the mutual love of this couple may grow daily and that God in his kindness will sustain all families throughout the world. For this bride and groom, John and Heather, and for their well-being as a family, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For their relatives and friends, and for all who have assisted this couple, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For young people preparing to enter marriage, and for all whom the Lord is calling to another state in life, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all families throughout the world, and for lasting peace among all people, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all members of our families who have passed from this world, and for all the faithful departed, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For the church, the holy people of God, and for unity among all Christians, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Lord Jesus, who are present in our midst, as John and Heather seal their union, accept our prayer and fill us with your Spirit, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated. Please stand. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all of God's church. Receive in your kindness, Lord, the offerings we bring in gladness before you, and in your fatherly love, watch over those you have joined in sacramental covenant. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you willed that the human race, created by the gift of your goodness, should be raised to such high dignity, that in the union of husband and wife, you might bestow a true image of your love. For those you created out of charity, you called to the law of charity without ceasing, and grant them a share in your eternal charity. And so the sacrament of holy matrimony, as the abiding sign of your own love, consecrates the love of man and woman through Christ our Lord. Through him, with the angels and all the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim. Please kneel or be seated. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, our local bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Please stand. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil." At this time, we offer what is called a nuptial blessing over the couple. And this is a blessing of the church because God knows we all need blessings in our lives, and particularly as we enter into a new life together as husband and wife. So I ask you and John and Heather to please face one another, and if you'd please join me in offering a blessing, I'll say the words if you could join me by raising your right arm over this couple as we extend to them this nuptial blessing. O God, who by your mighty power created all things out of nothing, and when you had set in place the beginnings of the universe, formed man and woman in your own image, making the woman an inseparable helpmate to the man, that they may no longer be two, but one flesh, and taught that what you were pleased to make one must never be divided. O God, who consecrated the bond of marriage by so great a mystery, that in the wedding covenant you foreshadowed the sacrament of Christ and his church. O God, by whom woman is joined to man, and the companionship they had in the beginning is endowed with the one blessing, not forfeited by original sin, nor washed away by the flood. Lord, look now with favor on these your servants joined together in marriage, who ask to be strengthened by your blessing. Send down on them the grace of the Holy Spirit and pour your love into their hearts, that they may remain faithful in marriage covenant. May the grace of love abide in your daughter Heather, and let her always follow the example of those holy women whose praises are sung in the scriptures. May her husband, John, entrust his heart to her, so that, acknowledging her as his equal and his joint heir to the life of grace, he may show her due honor and cherish all her always with the love that Christ has for his church. And now, Lord, we implore you, may these your servants hold fast to the faith and keep your commandments, made one in the flesh. May they be blameless in all they do, and with the strength that comes from the gospel, may they bear true witness to Christ before all. May they be blessed with children and prove themselves virtuous parents who live to see their children's children, and grant that, reaching at last together the fullness of years for which they hope, they may come to the life of the blessed in the kingdom of heaven through Christ our Lord. Amen. And Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. And let us extend to one another a sign of God's peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. At this time, I'd like to extend an invitation to those of the Catholic faith to please come forward and receive Holy Communion. If you're not of the Catholic faith or unable to receive at this time, We would still like to invite you to come forward to receive a blessing as we acknowledge the love between John and Heather on this, their wedding day. If you're coming forward to receive a blessing, please cross your arms over your chest.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Please stand. Receive in your kindness, Lord, the offerings that we bring in gladness before you. And in your fatherly love, watch over those you have joined in a sacramental covenant through Christ our Lord. And may God, the eternal Father, keep you of one heart in love for one another, that the peace of Christ may dwell in you and abide always in your home. Amen. May you be blessed in your children, have solace in your friends, and enjoy true peace with everyone. Amen. And may you be witnesses to the world to God's charity, so that the afflicted and the needy who have known your kindness may one day receive you thankfully into the eternal dwelling of God. Amen. And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. It is now my privilege to introduce to you for the first time in public, Mr. and Mrs. John and Heather Poff.
Who's ready to have a party tonight? Yeah. I don't know, that's kind of weak, guys. I said, are you ready to have a party tonight? Yeah. All right, now save the loudest applause for the bride and groom, but first we're going to introduce to you the bridal party. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to start off with my main man, AJ. Give it up for AJ, everybody. Come on down, AJ. That's right, brother. Bones. Yes, sir. Hey, get him a little bit. Get him a little bit. There you go. One more time for AJ. Next in line, give it up for Tara and David. Come on, give it up for Tara and David. Following. Tara and David, we have Lindsay and Ian. Give it up for Lindsay and Ian. That's right, that's right. Give it up, don't stop. Keep that applause going for Tiffany, Mitch, and Heather D. Yes, sir. You got a lady on both arms. Next in line, we have Heather B, Brian, and Angela. Come on, don't die on me. Keep the applause going, everybody. Keep it going. How about we give it up for the maid of honor and the best man, Jennifer and Steven. Now ladies and gentlemen, the moment we're all waiting for, the reason we are here this evening. Give it up for Mr. and Mrs. Pa! Give it up! Ladies and gentlemen, John and Heather Puff. All right. Now we invite the couple to remain on the dance floor as they share a dance together, their first dance as Mr. and Mrs. Loved by you.
How sweet it is to be loved by you. I needed the shelter. Stand my ups and downs. There you were. With sweet love and devotion. Deeply touching my emotion. I want to stop. Thank you, baby. I want to stop. And thank you, baby. Yes, I do. How sweet it is to be loved. Thank you, baby. Oh, yeah. How sweet it is to be loved by you. It's just like sugar sometimes. Come on, everybody, give it up for the party crew. Mr. and Mrs. Puff.
Okay, we're going to ask Mr. Puff to leave the dance floor, and we're going to invite the father of the bride to share a dance with his lovely daughter.
Look at the two of you dancing that way, lost in the moment and each other's face. So much in love, you're alone in this place, like there's nobody else in the world. I was enough for her not long ago. I was her number one. She told me so, and she still means the world to me, just so you know. So be careful when you hold my girl. Time changes everything, life must go on. I'm not gonna stand in your way. I loved her first, I held her first, and a place in my from the first breath she breathed, when she first smiled at me, I knew the love of a father runs deep. And I prayed that she'd find you someday, but it's still hard to give her away. I loved her first. How could that woman with you be the same freckle faced kid that I knew, the one that I read all those fairy tales to, and tucked into bed all those nights? And I knew the first time I saw you with her, it was only a matter of time.
From the first breath she breathed, when she first smiled at me, I knew the love of a father must be. And I prayed that she'd find you someday, but it's still hard to give her away. I loved her first.
One more time, ladies and gentlemen, for the father of the bride. Give it up. Now we have a special dance. We're gonna now invite the stepfather to share a dance as well with the bride.
I hope the days come easy and the moments pass slow. Road leads you where you wanna go. And if you're faced with a choice and you have to choose, I hope you choose the one that means the most to you. And if one door opens to another door closed, I hope you keep on walking till you find the window. If it's cold outside, show the world the warmth of your smile. But more than anything, more than anything,
ladies and gentlemen, for Heather's stepdad, sharing a beautiful dance together. All right, John, it's your turn, brother. We invite John and his beautiful mother to share a dance together on the dance floor.
Been introduced. All right, good evening, everybody. Welcome to the Poff Herbst wedding. I'd like to congratulate Mr. and Mrs. John Walter Poff. Where he is. So there. Yeah, well, didn't work out that way, did it? Yeah, it's all right. Okay, so before we begin the festivities that have been continuing since last night, and I got to meet. I cut off. There we go. Back on. all his buddies, and we had a great time. We've got some of our buddies over here from my childhood, and I'd like to also recognize the Herbst family and the Hello? Is this thing on? I might have been a comedian and told a joke that nobody could hear. Okay, so right here. So there's a sweet spot here. All right, we like to welcome the James clan and the Lanier clan and the Poff clan, the Keens, the Hadleys, the Caminettis, the Flints. Thanks for coming. So before we start, let's acknowledge the fact that this whole evening is a miracle. So let's bow our heads and pray for God's blessing. Dear Lord, we gather in this place in a spirit of celebration and gratitude. Thank you for the blessing of bringing John and Heather together in marriage. Sorry, I got to stand right here. God grant you all of life's blessings and love's joys. And may he bless you both on this day with a lifetime of shared love and joy. Dear Lord, please bless this food we are about to receive, and let this reception be in honor of you. In Jesus' name, amen. So, once again, welcome everybody. And let's see, we just came from a wedding not too long ago. It was our beautiful little niece, Aubrey, and her handsome groom, Ross McWaters. That was a lot of fun celebration. We'll probably have a few more in the coming years, so we're expecting all of that. So it was 7.5 years ago, July 2014, I guess, to be exact, when my son John brought this cute, demure little girl over to the house one evening with big eyes, and she introduced us. So she was, you know, kind of timid and quiet, and I was kind of wondering if she would ever be able to fit in with the rowdy Poff clan. You know, but it wasn't long before she fit in, and basically, we can't even imagine her not being part of the family now. Heather, look at this lady. Look at this bride. Doesn't she look beautiful? Well, the night that happened, he came down, and we sat out by the pool after he had introduced Heather to us, and he sat down and he leaned in and he said, "Dad, I think I'm gonna marry this girl." And so, you know, me being the father that wanted to dispense some wise words of wisdom, I thought of the first thing that came into my head, an old line from a Led Zeppelin song. "Don't lose your head to a woman who will spend your bread." Didn't take that advice, okay. And then I said something a little more cogent, you know. I said, "John, you are a responsible young man, and I know you will not enter into a marriage with a woman you love until you can support her." Okay, here it comes, guys. We talked about this last night, didn't we? So that was 7.5 years ago. And I guess he wanted to wait till he got his first million in the bank before he tied the knot. Now, I don't know how much he has in the bank. He doesn't divulge that. But apparently they're doing pretty well. So congratulations. Was that better? I got to tell you, we had a lot of fun last night. John's got a great group of friends and a hands out to you. Steven, you've done so much. Step back. Tom and Mitch, who else? And David, yes. Okay, good. And Brian, I'm sorry. I have a good, oh yeah, that's right. The Scotch guy. Brian brought over I was a naval attaché in Egypt, and I was taught how to drink scotch by the Swiss attaché. So I learned to drink Isle of Malts, fell in love with the real smoky stuff, the Lafroig and the Lagavulin, and my buddies over here, yeah, they know. You guys, you know that I was in a rock band. I used to be pretty cool. That's right, I'm an old man, I tend to wander. But anyways, these are the guys I played with, and they knew all about our song, Collision. They just re-released an old song of ours. So we had a great time. But anyways, Brian brought over a bottle of, what was it, Ardberg or something? And I gave a nice critique of it, told him I didn't like it very much, and then drank half the bottle. Not quite. I woke up this morning feeling wonderful. And also Josh brought over your awesome brother-in-law, who's right here, brought over some wonderful scotches. We had actually most of us are over here in the corner. And it's like a little, early American kind of a village, right? And John came through the house, last night, and he says, I'm organizing a raiding party. I said, what's a raiding party? He says, it's a group of strong young men out to do illegal things. You've forgotten that? Oh, okay. Well, this is the night that we do that, right? Okay, so anyways, not to make a long story even longer, we had a great time. John came into this world October the 2nd, 1983, and we moved around quite a bit. And he was a serious little boy, actually. You know, he didn't talk too much, didn't say too many words, and he was very thoughtful. The first time I remember him doing something, thought out, was he was trying to teach himself to run. And he was outside the house, and he was thinking about it. And he put one foot forward and then couldn't figure out how to put his arm, So he was going like this. Figured it out and started running. And pretty soon he was running all over the neighborhood and getting lost. John turned out to be a pretty good athlete, as we found out. They were teaching us, the kids in the area, how to swim. So the parents were brought out, and we were told to watch the kids jump. And all his contemporaries were jumping in and holding on to the pool. John looked down at the deep end, took a deep breath, and jumped right in. Boy, my buttons popped, because the kid was fearless. Soon thereafter, he was playing soccer and running around the field. And of course, I was the obnoxious parent that stood there and yelled louder than anybody. The coach and the rest of the parents, be quiet, So sorry about that, but I was your biggest fan. Good. Not long after that, we ended up in San Diego, and John was playing soccer, then he was playing basketball. Here's a funny story. John decided he wanted to get a cool haircut, so his mother brought him over, and he got this neat haircut, and it was a little bit like a mullet, when mullets were fashionable, little kid. And all the kids on the court thought he looked so cool, they didn't touch him the whole game, and John scored more points the whole game. I said, John, you ought to keep that up. A couple years later, he was playing football and ended up being the most valuable player. This was your junior year, right? So John was tough. They played him the whole season on offense and defense. I don't know how he did it, but he ended up winning the trophy. So he was a pretty good athlete. Well, I just want to refer to a couple of... Yep. No. Yeah. Okay, I found my... Anyways, after my retirement, I ended up moving back down to West Palm Beach. And as it turned out, we were about a mile from Heather's parents' family. And this was right after they met. John came down, introduced me to Heather. We found out that Deborah and Jean and Robin lived in the same area. I think John's head wanted to explode. It wasn't long after that that we were hanging out together and talking story and all that stuff. So we've been like family for years already in many ways. So well, anyways, just want to congratulate you two and just let you know how proud we are of you. And I'd like to raise a toast if I can find something to raise it with. I need some scotch. All right, Heather and John, may you be blessed all your life, and we love you. To John and Heather. Let the games begin.
Give it up, everybody, for father of the groom, Tom.
All right. First, I just want to start off and say, I mean, what a wonderful ceremony that was. That was awesome. That was just beautiful. It's turned out to be such a special day, and everyone here, we're going to remember this for a long, long time. So that's awesome. Also, I want to thank everyone for coming out. I want to thank everyone for coming out to celebrate John and Heather. As it means the world to them. So I really appreciate you all being there in this crazy time. So it really means a lot for you all to be here. So thank you very much. And also want to just call a few people out here that's just been really special to John and Heather, and you know, have shaped them and molded them and got them to where they are today. So I want to thank Jean and Debbie here. Jean and Debbie. Also, Robin and Linda. And another Linda. I want to thank John's mom, Linda. And also, Tom... Tom Poff and Elena. And special thanks to Tom. What a great night that was last night. That was really awesome. So thanks for the Harborside. So many friends and family here. It's just really great. And we also have this is special. I know Tom, you already talked about it. But we have a reunion of sorts, right? The band Collision is here. Shout out to Collision. Can we get a performance later? What do we think? Yeah, they're gonna do it. This is great. One time only, right? You're back in action. One time only. All right. Has it been 50 years since the start? I can't remember either. Yeah, there we go. Well, hopefully we can get a performance here. But the man of the hour, John Poff. John Poff has been a brother to me. We've known each other for over 20 years. That's crazy. That's a long time. So we grew up together. And how did we meet? We met at Sports Authority, right? John and I tried to keep Sports Authority afloat. We did our best. Things were going well. And then, you know, we moved on in life and got rid of Sports Authority. And there was this rival that moved in across the street. They'll remain nameless, but If you're in the Citrus Park era, you know that other sporting goods store is still there and Sports Authority is not, but that's probably more because we left, I'm guessing. So, anyways. So John worked in just about every department out there, right? I mean, he was out there doing his thing, out and about. And I worked up front. I was in the front taking all the sales. So he would make the sales essentially, send them off to me, and then I would cash them out and get them on their way. So you were much more important job than I was.
No way, you're handling the money.
Yeah, I was handling the money, yeah. Hopefully the register counted up at the end of the night, yeah. There's ups and downs at Sports Authority. There's highs and lows, right, as in any job. So what did we do to fill the down times? We tried to make time pass quickly. They had a golf simulator, so we would, yes, on the clock, maybe we would sneak off and play in the golf simulator, hit some balls, check out new equipment, things like that, or make prank phone calls. That's right, prank phone calls. But not to people, to other sports authorities. That's what we would do. So for fun, we had this old like 1980s computer that, you know, we could tap into the inventory of all the other sports authorities. So we got pretty good at that, and we would search random things that sports authorities shouldn't have, right? And what I mean by this is we'd search, and some sports authority on Hillsborough Avenue maybe had an NSYNC poster or a Britney Spears poster. It's like, why would they have that? Well, I don't know. They had it in some random corner. It was in the inventory. So John and I thought it would be fun to call these other sports authorities at work and tell them, hey, we were just in there and we really want that Britney Spears poster. Can you place it on hold for us? And they'd go, yeah, sure. And then we'd call them back like 15 minutes later, and sometimes they'd say, we don't have that. Like, we were just in the store, and you guys definitely have it. Can you put it on hold? We're coming right now to buy it. So.
There's 20 of these posters. They're not going to sell out in there.
Yeah, they would give us like, there's 20, no, we're not going to sell out. Just stop. Stop calling us.
Make sure one's behind.
Make sure one's behind. So we really enjoyed doing that in our downtime. So outside of work, you know, we shared the same passions. Part of what the great thing at Sports Authority, if we worked the morning shift, we could get out by 2:30 and still go play 18 holes of golf, which we did all the time. Other things we did, you know, our passions was live music. I think one of the things that we did and we loved, we'd go see concerts. And I think as we were growing up as well, you know, this was kind of the first time in our life we can go out and pay for our own vacations and travel and go to these great places and see these bands that we wanted to do. We'd go to cities like Boston, we'd go to Chicago, we'd go to New Orleans. In fact, New Orleans, I think one year we went, we had six guys, one king bed, one room. We did it. So I think John and I slept on the floor. I slept by a door. I got hit in the head when one of the other guys came back at the end of the night. It was just a great time in our life to grow up and just do all these fun things. And we really shared life's amazing moments and accomplishments and grew up together, again, as brothers. And what you want in a brother, you know, you want to make sure your other brother is okay, and you want to see what he's up to, and also you kind of want to validate, right, who he's dating, right? So as a big brother or little brother or whatever, you want to make sure who they're dating is good for him. So, John, you know, let me know. Hey, I'm dating Heather, and you know, we got to meet her, and you know, of course, I'm probably going to judge Heather maybe more than others, right? Because I care so much for John. He's such a great friend. Right, exactly. But it turns out when I met Heather, I mean, she was just one of the nicest, kindest, sweetest, most beautiful girls that you're ever going to meet. So Bravo. You really did a great job. But 7.5 years ago, something like that? That's awesome. So right away, you knew it would be different. Like, you knew that this was going to be really special. Flash forward, they have a beautiful home, two great dogs now there at the house. And time just flies. It seems like yesterday. So what a lovely couple. What a lovely day. You two are the best. One of my best friends. Thank you so much. Thanks for having us all here. Let's raise a toast. Let's celebrate this great couple here. To John and Heather. Many years of happiness. Congratulations.
Well done, Stephen. Well done. We now invite Lindsay. Lindsay. Stephen, if you could hand the microphone to Lindsay for me, please. Where is Lindsay? Pigeon Lindsay? Oh, there she is. Oh.
Thank you, Stephen. Yep, right there. Okay. Hi, everyone. I'm Lindsay. John's sister. For those of you who don't know, John's first name is actually brother. It's not John. He's always brother to me, so feel free to also just call him brother. I'm going to keep this short and sweet because this baby could come at any minute. Earlier this week, my husband and son and I drove down to Florida from Washington, D.C., and we drove for 2 days. We thought, you know, we may never get here and see this day. Not because it was a long drive, but because we've all been waiting almost 8 years for tonight. So I want to raise a glass to our dear, sweet Heather, who I love so much, for being the most patient girlfriend you could imagine. When I first met Heather, sorry. Something she said to me that I'll never forget was, she said, "I have been praying. I've been praying for God to send me a man like your brother." And so, thank you, Heather, for praying for my brother. And thank you, God, for answering her prayer. So please join me in raising a glass to answered prayers and to Brother and Heather.
That was well done, girl. Beautiful. I think you have a future at stand-up with Lindsay. You're good, girl. You're good. We now invite
Jennifer. Woo!
Jennifer. Where's the maid of honor? Is she ready?
Right here.
All right. We invite the maid of honor, ladies and gentlemen.
Lindsay, I was holding it together until you started that last part. Oh boy. Okay. Good evening, everyone. Thank you so much for being here. It means so much to John and Heather, and we're just so excited about them being together. They're so much better together. So, I'm Jennifer. I'm Heather's big sister and BFF since 1985. If you don't already know, we are sappy and criers, so get your tissues ready. Here we go. If you know Heather, you love Heather. She is one of the easiest people to get along with. Hang with and just have fun with. There are very few who do not become fast friends with Heather. There is not a person around her that she doesn't care for and love. I have had this privilege since her birth. One of my favorite memories my mom shares of us is the moment Heather was born. My mom gave me the best gift ever, my very own personal baby doll. I would literally drag Heather around the house by her footy pajamas, creating knots of all kinds in her long, beautiful hair. And on occasion, as babies need, I would try to change a diaper or two, and I would get into lots of trouble for that. As we got older, the baby doll thing turned into she was now my student in my very own makeshift classroom. We eventually found music, friends, clothes, and cars. And in fun fashion, my sister Tara, her very first car was a car that the back would just fly open by itself. So Tara would hold one of our feet as we closed it while driving, very unsafe. But we loved turning on music and singing at the top of our lungs. And I know that's one of Heather's passions still today. She loves to sing, and she has one of the prettiest voices I've ever heard. So for her, to find a musical family is not surprising. She fits in so well with all of you. My memories of my baby sis are simple. Knotted hair, our ragamuffin, as Jean would call her. Spiffed out in her favorite purple jumpsuit and jelly shoes. All matching, by the way. And my mom could not rip that off of her to wash it at any point in her little life. Sweet cuddles in the middle of the night because big sis was too scared to sleep alone. I always felt comfortable with her by my side, and I still do. My friends were her friends, and I was absolutely fine with it, and my mom wouldn't allow anything else. She was my best friend, so of course she was with me everywhere I went, getting in trouble, swapping clothes, usually at her annoyance because I would just take it when I wanted. And singing everywhere we went. She was my first baby doll, but you're my forever friend. Heather, besides my kids and my awesome, amazing husband, you are the most important person in my life. No matter where life has taken us, you have always been just a phone call away. And oh, how sweet those phone calls have been. They have been some of the best cry sessions, laugh sessions, and just what I need every single time. I cherish them, and our time together is always even sweeter. I'm not losing a sister. I'm gaining a brother, a sister, and a whole other family that I've had the privilege of spending time with, and you're all amazing. Heather is one lucky girl. John, if your marriage is anything, like Heather and I's friendship, you are one blessed man. I know that your marriage will be good because you are a good man. You're steady, smart, and you are both great together. I love you, John. Thank you for loving Heather and taking care of her. Forgive each other and forgive often. Nothing is too serious to not work it out. Life's too short. Just forgive and move on. Don't sweat the small stuff. P.S. Most of the fights will be the small stuff. Enjoy every second. Laugh, adventure together, communicate often, and even about the mundane stuff. And keep Jesus at the forefront of it all. He is constant, trustworthy, and loves you both more than anyone else ever could. He wants you to succeed and grow as a married couple. He is the glue that will help hold it all together. So in closing, let me read a blessing out of the Bible for you from Numbers 6, 24 through 26. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Can everyone please raise your glasses to Heather and John? Congratulations. We love you.
Yeah. you heard John's dad say, "I'm proud of you as his son," right? So here we go now. He's gonna toss this thing like a true football player. Let's go. You ready, my brother? On three. 1, 2, 3. Let it go, baby. All right, he's got it. We got ourselves a wide receiver.